Good morning, one and all. So let us start today's class with a new topic, that is inference and the continuous Bayes rule. Here, so we have already studied the Bayes rule in the last classes. So we will study this Bayes rule in case of continuous random variables. Before that, this is what is the relation between joint PDF and conditional PDF and marginal PDF. So similar kind of equation we have written in case of discrete random variables. So simply you remember this. This gives the whole idea of joint PDF. If x comma y equal to fx into f y given x, this also equal to fy into f x given y. So this is the equality which defines. This is joint PDF, this is marginal PDF, this is a conditional PDF. Now similarly you can write for PMF also. I hope you have written similar kind of equation for discrete random variable. What do you write? Px p y given x, that is also equal to py p x given y. Now, so if you remember this equality, it gives the relation between joint PDF and conditional PDFs. Now here we are writing the Bayes rule, correct? So what the Bayes rule we know? Suppose P of A given B, if I ask you. What the Bayes rule? Basically this is equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. But what is P of A intersection B can also be written as? What do you write? So further you can write that as, what do you write? P of A into P of B given A by P of B. This is a Bayes rule, isn't it? Now we are writing the Bayes rule using PDFs, that's it. So here what you have written here? F of x given y of x given y equal to f x of x into f of y given x by f y of y. So this is a Bayes rule for the continuous random variable using PDFs. Is it okay? What do you written? So you go, you observe with this formula, compare with this formula. P of a given b equal to p of a into P of B given A by P of what? B. Now you just compare these two, this equation with this equation. Here we are writing probabilities, here we are writing conditional PDFs or marginal PDFs. Okay. So no need to worry about this formula, it is exactly the same. The only thing is we write the different notations, that's it. Right. So next we move on to another topic, that is functions of one random variable. Here, so we have two random variables, x and y. But they are related with some function. What is that? Y equal to function of x. Then here, what is known to us? We know the PDF of x. We know the PDF of x, but we have to find what? PDF of y. That is the question. So x and y are related, but here you know the PDF of x, but you don't know PDF of y. So we have to find out PDF of y. Now, so to find out that PDF, we have a two steps. We have a two step approach. Okay. What is that? What the first step? First, calculate CDF of y. First, calculate CDF of y using the formula. What formula will you use? This formula. So this is the CDF of Y. It is defined like this. But what is capital Y? Capital Y equal to G of X. G of X less than Y. Now this is the formula. Okay, we will solve some problem. Don't get confused by looking at the formula. It is very simple. Okay. Then what do you do now? So you got CDF of Y. But what do you want? You want PDF of Y. So how to get it? By differentiation. So this is the second step. Okay. So let me write the steps. So here we have a relation. What relation? Y is a function of X. Some function g or f, whatever it is. So what do we do first? We find out CDF of Y. Next step. What do we do next? That's the first thing we do. Next, after that, we find out PDF of Y. That's it. These are two steps. Step 1, step 2. How we find out CDF? We go with the basic formula. Fi of Y. What is the formula? Probability that capital Y is less than equal to small y. After getting CDF, we get PDF. How? By differentiation. So this can be achieved by what? Simple differentiation. Okay. So we'll take one problem and we solve it. So please remember the steps. There are only two steps. They are the easiest way. That is the easiest way. Now, what is given in the problem? Read the problem properly. So X is a uniform on 0 to 1. So let me draw this. X is a uniform random variable from where to where? 0 to 1. This is also 1. No need to write, no need to tell you exactly what is what each and every time. This is the PDF of X. Okay, find the PDF of Y given that how Y is related to X with a square root operation. Here, what is the function? G. It is a square root operation, SQRT. It is a non-linear function anyway. Okay, so just let me write the problem here. You read the problem properly. So what they are saying is, X is a uniform random variable, uniform. So it is from where to where? X belongs to 0 to 1, isn't it? But what is Y? Y is another random variable, that is square root of X. What they are asking? What is the PDF of Y? You have to find out what is the PDF of Y. Okay, so now suppose if X is 0 to 1, what about Y? It is also belongs to 0 to 1 because it is a square root operation. Is it okay? So this is very, very important. You must find out the limits of both random variables. Here X also belongs to 0 to 1, Y also belongs to 0 to 1. Is it okay? Now let us proceed. Here Y equal to square root of X. Now what is step 1 I told you? Step 1 should be find what? CDF of what? Y. Which means Fy of Y. What is the basic definition? Probability that capital Y is less than equal to small y. Isn't it? But what is capital Y? That equal to square root of X. Substitute here. So let us proceed further. Okay, so further that is equal to probability that capital Y equal to square root of X. X less than equal to small y. Now if I square both sides, I mean this is can be further written as probability that X is less than equal to Y square. Is it okay? But here, what is the random variable x? The random variable is x. Now, so what do you mean by this? What about x? We know x. X is a uniform random variable in the range of 0 to 1. So let me draw here. Zero to one, it is also one. This is what PDF of x. So they are asking x is less than or equal to y square. Means what? What about y square value? Y square also what belongs to 0 to 1? Why? Because y also belongs to 0 to 1, which means y square is somewhere here. It is between 0 and 1. Anyway, y square can never be negative and it is not more than 1. Why? Because y is also not more than 1. Which means, what do you mean by this? They are asking this area. What is this area? This is y square, this is 1. Are you getting what I am saying? So, which means, so probability that x is less than or equal to y square is equal to y square. Do you agree or not? Why? Because what is this area? This is y square, this is a rectangle, no? Y square into 1, y square. Here it is between 0 and 1. Please remember 0 less than y less than or equal to 1. Now, what is this? What you are finding? CDF of y. Okay. So, yeah. Let me write the CDF of y properly. Now, first step is over. Fi of y equal to, it is y square. If it is 0 less than y less than equal to 1. Since it is CDF, Suppose y square is here, let us take for example. Then what would happen? It is CDF. What do you write? It is 1 if y is more than 1. Okay, anyway, we don't write this more than 1, but since it is CDF, it should be 1 maximum. Next, this is step 1. From this, we should proceed to step 2. What is step 2? Find the PDF. So you know CDF, you should find PDF. What? Simple differentiation. Isn't it? Now here PDF will be Fi of y equal to differentiation of CDF. Do the differential and tell me the answer first. What do you get? So what a differentiation of y square? 2y. What a differentiation of 1? 0. So it is 2y if y is 0 to 1. 0 otherwise or elsewhere. Okay, so that is the answer. So this is the final answer. These are two steps, that's it. Please follow the steps carefully. Okay. So now let us take one more problem in the same category. So Raju is driving from Hyderabad to Mumbai, a distance of how much miles? 180 miles. His average speed is uniform distributed. Yes. Now x is the speed, average speed. Now let us call x is the speed of Raju. How it is defined? It is random variable which is uniform distributed between 30 to 60 miles per hour. What is the PDF of duration of the trip? So observe the problem carefully. So let us proceed further. So Raju is going from Hyderabad to Mumbai. So let me write this. He is going from where to where? Hyderabad to Mumbai. Distance is 180 miles. So here, now let us call, what we know? We know that his speed is modeled as a uniform random variable between 30 to 60 miles per hour. So first of all, so let us write the PDF of x. What is x actually? X is a speed. Here speed is a random variable, speed of the Raju. PDF of x, that is fx of x. So since it is uniform from 30 to 60, I hope you can simply draw it. Don't you? Please draw. Otherwise, let me write this. What it will become? Fx of x equal to, so 30 to 60 means what a difference? 30. Obviously, it is 1 by 30. So 30 less than equal to x less than equal to 30 less than equal to x less than equal to 60, 0 otherwise. Now this is the PDF of x. Next, so what is CDF of x? That is f y of y. So I am finding what are known quantities first. Anybody? This is standard form, no? What will you write here? So uniform random variable between a and b, we say, which means a equal to 30, b equal to 60. That's why I written 1 by b minus a, means 1 by 30 between a and b. Next, what is the CDF? So I will write directly, you find out later, because we have solved this already in general case using a and b. Here what is a equal to 30, b equal to 60, that's it. It is 0 if x is less than a. Am I okay? It is x minus a by b minus a. X minus 30 by b minus is also 30. I hope you remember this. If you don't remember, you go and check the previous classes. So don't waste time here. Between 30 to 60. Next, it is 1 if it is more than 60. Do you agree or not? Okay. Yeah, so till now, what we got so far? PDF of x, from that we got CDF of x. X is uniform random variable, it is the speed of the Raju. But so what is the problem actually? What they are asking in the problem? What is the PDF of duration of the trip? Duration means time taking, time. Now let us call y is the duration of the trip. How much time it takes? Duration means time taking. How much time it takes? So how to find time? It is a distance by speed. Isn't it? Time equal to distance by speed. Which means how much the distance between Mumbai and Hyderabad? Y is a time. That is distance 180 miles by speed. Speed is a random variable. X is the speed, which is uniform distributed random variable. So now this is the relation between y and x. Okay, so they have written like this. Okay, let us proceed now. What the first step we do generally? step 1. So to find CDF of y. Okay, which means fy of y, that is defined as probability that capital Y is less than equal to small y. But what is capital Y? It is 180 by capital X. Substitute here. Follow the same process, very simple. Probability that 180 by capital X less than equal to small y. But here, what is the variable? Capital X. Now, this can be further written as probability that, what you can write? X is greater than or equal to 180 by y. Do you agree? Is it okay? Now, but, so in CDF, everything will be less than only, right? CDF means less than. Here we got greater than. So, we can do one thing. What we can do? We can write 1 minus probability that, what you can say? X is less than 180 by y. I am writing 1 minus. Now, this is in the standard form of CDF. What is that? What is this? So, this is some variable. This is a random variable. X. X less than equal small x. Let us take. What do you write then? So, be careful. It is nothing but fx of 180 by y. Is it okay? Otherwise, let me recall here. So, capital fx of x, this is CDF of x equal to probability that capital X is less than or equal to less than small x. So, here wherever there is small x, we have 180 by y. In place of small x, what we have? 180 by y. That's why wherever there is small x, I am writing 180 by y. So, please remember, now this is, okay. So, let me write properly here. So, I am just comparing with the standard form of CDF of x. Now, finally, please don't deviate from topic. So, the CDF of y equal to, 1 minus fx of 180 by y is stuck here. But what we know this already, CDF of x, what is that? We found out, no? Where is that? Yeah. Now, here, which means, what do you do now? Wherever there is small x, you have to replace how much? 180 by y. That's it. Wherever there is small x, you replace 180 by y and you have to subtract from 1. Okay. So, let me write that one more time for you. So, before that, let me write fx of x here for your convenience. What is fx of x? Capital fx of x. 0 if it is less than 30. Next, x minus 30 by 30 if it is between 30 and 60. And it is 1 if it is more than 60. Is it okay? Yeah, same thing we have replaced here. So next, there are simple calculations. Okay, which means fy of y equal to 1 minus CDF of x. But in place of small x, we have what? 180 by y. This is small x actually. So, we have to replace small x with 180 by y in this expression. And after that, we have to subtract it from 1. Okay. So, I think you can do this on your own. I am simply writing for you. Okay. You do calculations later. You get like this. Okay. What do you get? 0. If y is less than 3, which means the first statement, okay. Next, it is It is 2 minus 6 by y. I am not doing all simple calculations. You do it later. If it is between 3 to 6. If it is more than 6. So I will tell you simple logic. Wherever there is x, you should replace with 180 by y. That's it. Now you got CDF of what? Y. Now from this you should get second step. What is second step says? Differentiation. You get PDF of y, that is fy of y. So that is very simple. 0, if it is less than 3, 6 by how much? Y square, it is between 3 to 6. And 0 again if it is more than 6. It is just differentiation. Differentiation of 1 is 0. Differentiation of 2 minus 6 by y is 6 by y square. That's it. Okay. Now, so what we have done so far? Okay. First of all, so let me write using some pictures. What we know? We know that PDF of x we know, because they mentioned that it is a uniform random variable from 30 to 60, which means it is 30 to 60 miles per hour. This is x. Obviously, this should be how much? This is PDF of x. This should be 1 by 30. This we know. From that, we have found out CDF of x. Please don't forget. So how it was? It was just like this. Remember properly, this is CDF of x. Okay, what is the value? This is 30. And what is this? This is 60. What is this value? That is 1. So what is this line? X minus 30 by 30. We have drawn this kind of graph for the uniform random variable. While discussing uniform random variable, I have written there itself. A is 30, B is 60, that's it. Here A, this is A, this is B. This is what? X minus A by B minus A. This is 1 after 60, after B. Next, here is the logic. Now you follow the arrows. That is very, very important. So from CDF of X, what do you got? You got CDF of y. Okay. You got CDF of y. You got some values. What do you got? Something like this. I'm just drawing this. This is 1. This is 3. This is 6. What is this? CDF of what? Y. Now from this differentiation you got PDF of x. From this, the differentiation, you got CDF of x. Now PDF of x, sorry. It will be something like this. This is 3, this is 6. Y. Finally, this is your answer. So you follow this arrows. This arrows indicates the procedure. PDF of x, from that CDF of x, from that CDF of y, from that PDF of y. Is it okay? Right. Okay, so we are running out of time. Let us move on to the next thing. Yeah. So here we have one more thing, that is you do one thing, you take it as homework. This is very, very important problem. Next. So this is one of the important topics again. So PDF of a linear function of a random variable. So till now we have discussed non-linear functions. Okay, what happens here? Y equal to x square is a non-linear function. It is also non-linear because y equal to 180 by x. Here y equal to root x. There are non-linear functions. So let us say what happens to the linear functions. Now how y is depends upon x, that is ax plus b. When a and b are scalars, a is not equal to 0. Then what is the PDF of y? So this is a definition. I am not doing the proof, but it's very, very important. 1 by mod a, let me write here. So y is equal to ax plus b. What we know here? We know the PDF of x. The what we know? If x of x is known to us, we have to find out PDF of y. Again, same logic. But here, we don't need any steps. I am directly giving you the formula. If it is linear, fi of y equal to, what is that? 1 by mod a. Don't forget mod a. It's very, very important. Fx of what? Y minus b by a. Which means, so if you compare with this, this is PDF of x having random variable capital X and small x is any value. So only thing is, in place of small x, we have y minus b by a. Which means, first get the PDF of x, in that substitute small x with what? Y minus b by a, and later multiply with 1 by mod a, you get PDF of y. Is it okay? So I am not doing the proof, but so you can do the proof very easily. Okay. Let us take a simple problem. So here we don't need any two steps. It is direct. I am giving the formula directly. When it is true, please remember, it should be in this form only, y equal to x plus b form. A linear function of an exponential random variable. Okay, so let us take a linear function of an exponential random variable. First of all, so what they are saying is, x is exponential random variable with a PDF we know already. It is known to us. What is that? Lambda into e power minus lambda x, if x is greater than or equal to 0, 0 otherwise. Okay. Here lambda is any positive parameter. Lambda is also any positive parameter. Now, but here we have one more random variable y, that equal to ax plus b, where a and b are scalars, a is not equal to 0. Let us take like that. Now we have to find out PDF of y. What they are asking? Find out PDF of y. What formula I told you? That is 1 by mod a fx of y minus b by a. Only thing is, in the expression of PDF of x, wherever there is small x, you write 1 y minus b by a, and after that multiply with 1 by mod a. Is it okay? That is only logic we should follow. So here what happens now? So what happens? Please follow carefully. Lambda is there, lambda by mod a. I multiply with 1 by mod a. What is there here? Lambda is there now. So this into 1 by mod a, lambda by mod a into e power minus lambda. So wherever there is x, you must write y minus b by a, lambda into, please be careful, y minus b by a. This is true when x is more than 0, which means y minus b by a is more than 0. That is also true, right? Next, it is 0 elsewhere means 0 means 0 only. 0 elsewhere. So that is the simple logic. Now, what is the PDF of y? F y of y equal to lambda by mod a. Let me write like this, lambda by mod a into e power minus lambda into, what you can say, y minus b by a, y minus b by a. So it is true when y is more than, y is greater than or equal to b. So if you solve this, what do you get? Y is greater than or equal to b. I am writing simplified. 0 otherwise. The question is, what about y? Is it also exponential? X is exponential. Is y also exponential? Think about it. This is a question mark. Very, very important. But let me take a simple thing. Suppose if b equal to 0 and a is positive. Let us take the case. In this, b equal to 0 and a is positive. What will happen? What will happen? So let me write carefully. Fi of y equal to b 0, a is positive. Since a is positive, mod a is nothing but a. That's why lambda by a, this is equal to lambda by a into e power minus b 0 means minus lambda into y by a, minus lambda into y by a. Next, y is greater than or equal to b, b is 0, y is greater than or equal to 0. 0 otherwise. Okay, so in this special case, is it exponential? What is the difference? Only difference is with the parameter not lambda, lambda by a. With parameter lambda by a. Y is exponential. With parameter not lambda, lambda by a. Is it true always? You think about this. In this special case, it is exponential, but will it be always exponential? So that is the point of discussion. You think about it. Okay, a linear function of a normal random variable. We do same thing for normal random variable. What will happen? So first let me write x is a normal random variable with mu and sigma square. What is the PDF? 1 over root 2 pi sigma square e power minus x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. It is true for all x, right? Now what is fi of y? Wherever there is x, you must write y minus b by a. So fi of x equal to 1 by square root of mod a. So let me write mod a also. 1 by mod a into root 2 pi sigma square into, wherever there is x, you must write y minus b by a, into e power minus y minus b by a minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. So you please bear with the calculations, and you do the calculation on your own, it will be very easy now. Now I can simply write 1 by mod a into root 2 pi sigma square into 2 pi sigma square. It will become, let me write properly, e power minus y minus b minus a mu whole square by, what will happen, 2 sigma square and a square. Okay, this is the p dep of y. Yes, the question is, now is it normal? Normal or not? Compare with a normal PDF. This is a normal PDF. Is it normal or not? Yes, it is always normal. But the only change is, here the mean is not mu. What is the mean? What is the mean? A mu plus B. You try to understand the things properly. What are the variants? A square into sigma square. Normal. Okay, let me write properly here. Y is always normal. With a mean A mu plus B. With a variance A square into sigma square. This is a very, very important thing. So the linear transformation of a normal random variable is always normal random variable. But what about exponential? We don't know. The linear transformation of exponential random variable need not be exponential. It is exponential under some special conditions. But here I did not take any special conditions. It is always normal. Okay. Here also, I forgot to tell you, you can take this inside the square, it becomes mod a square sigma square. Okay, yeah, you rearrange the things properly. You rearrange the things properly, you get that y is also normal random variable with mean a mu plus b and variance a square into sigma square. So the point I want to make is, mean is a mu plus b with a variance a square into sigma square. Is it okay? Now, so this is about linear function of random variable. Okay, so let me solve this problem also. So they are saying y equal to x square. X is a random variable with known PDF. We don't know what is that, but we know PDF. Okay, so y equal to, this is a relation between y and x, this is a nonlinear relation. X is having PDF is known to us. We want to know what is unknown to us, PDF of y. We have to follow two steps. Step 1, first we have to find CDF of y. Is it okay? Do it first. Okay, let me follow the steps properly. If y of y equal to probability that capital Y is less than equal to small y. What is capital Y equal to? X square. which means this implies that probability that x square is less than equal to y. Okay. Now, how can I write this? Please be careful here. I can write this as probability that minus root y less than equal to x less than equal to root y. Can I do so or not? Suppose if I say x square is less than equal to 1, if I say x square is less than equal to 1, which means I can write it is between minus 1 less than equal to x less than equal to 1. In the same way, here instead of 1 we have y. I should take root also. Okay, should take root. I am taking root both sides. So this is what you get. Now what you can write this further? Can anybody tell me? What you can write here? It is between A and B, let us take. What do you write here? You can write fx of, be careful, root y minus fx of minus root y. How can I write like this? You think of it. Very simple. Before that, so if x is y equal to x square, what about y? Y is always positive, no? You must write the range of y also. Y is always positive. Is it okay? Why? Because it is square of something. Yeah, keep that in mind. That is step 1. What is step 2? PDF of y. How? By differentiation. What is differentiation? What do you get? Differentiate this with respect to y. What do you get? What is the differentiation of root y? What is that? So let me write here. Now I am writing fx of x. That is 1 by 2 root y. This is the differentiation of root y. Is it okay? Next. Fx of root y. Here it should be small y. If you differentiate this part, you get this. Next. Next, what do you get? Plus 1 by 2 root y into fx of minus root y. Now this further can be written as, what is the common thing? 1 by 2 root y. If that is common, fx of root y plus fx of minus root y. This is the logic. But here remember, y should be greater than or equal to 0. If it is 0 for y less than 0. Is it okay? So the important thing is this. How can you write like this? You think of it. It is very simple. Okay. Right. So we stop here. Thank you.